went to the 48-hour film festival screening of The Horror Project and was mind blown by what some of these filmmakers could come up with in just one weekend. If you guys don't know what the 48-hour film festival is, it's a project that comes around a couple times a year. It was here in July and then again just in October. Ahead of time, you get a crew together, a whole film crew with producers, writers, directors, actors. You scout locations. You do everything you possibly can beforehand. And then the weekend of, you're given three things on a Friday night. One, a prop. Two, a line of dialogue. And three, a character. And then you have to incorporate all those things into a script and then go through pre-production, production, and post-production, all within 48 hours to turn your film in. And then the following weekend, the films are screened for an audience, and awards are given away, some audience choice and some by a panel of judges. Afterwards, I caught up with the Carnegie Screenwriters crew who created The Last Rain.
About 2 months ago, Joseph and I wanted to make a outlandish, over-the-top horror film for the 48-hour film entry, and we started looking for locations and stuff, and I had been working with Randy on this sitcom called Downsized, as well as Joe, and we both said to Joe, and I said to Joe, we should bring Randy on as a producer. He agreed, and I said, Randy, we want to bring you on as a producer, and he was like, cool.
Cool, dude.
And I said, we really want to shoot in Carnegie. I have some connections there. Randy said, I do too.
I do.
And so we did a little bit of location scouting. Then we basically called up every person we've ever worked with in the last 3 years and built an army, because we wanted them, because we knew, and we worked with some great people, and we knew that if they weren't on our team, we were going to compete against them.
The story came together from Friday night. Almost seamlessly. It's kind of crazy how well everything gelled. It was like a really fine-tuned watch.
Right after we finished the script about 12:30 in the evening, which is pretty early for this project, one of the first things I had to do was call up Eve, and basically we spent about half an hour talking about death and how we were going to kill people, the different ways we could do it, the easiest ways, prosthetic-wise. All right, Eve, can you tear his cheek? I need to get a picture for it. So then I had to search for some of the most terrible pictures I've ever seen in my entire life for reference. It was a good time.
48 hours later, actually the very first movie turned in this year, from what I understand, right?
Yes.
Is that right?
We were the very first movie. We were the very first movie. I stayed up all night editing it and then sent it off to Chris, and I didn't sleep for 40 straight hours.
Be sure to find The Last Rain on YouTube, as well as look for all the other films that were created. Check out the 48-Hour Film Festival website for here in Pittsburgh, as well as all around, to see what happened this year and what's coming for next year.
You know,
Carnegie Screenwriters. It was fun, though. It was a fun nightmare.
Eve showed us how to gouge out eyeballs without actually hurting the actress. And it looked good.
Oh, it looked real good. It did.
The Millennium Dance Complex in Southside offers weekly classes in ballet, hip-hop, contemporary, tap, jazz, and burlesque. Get the highest level of service and instruction at Pittsburgh's ultimate dance experience. Visit our website for complete class schedule.